Here we go. Ding, 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 Booker, so guys, what wouldn't you do in order to find a way to wake up in the morning on fire? Wait to, as you're waking up, your mom is on fire. Or you already are, I guess. It's not an issue. No, you guys,
literally.
Not literally on fire. No. Not literally on fire, but that mom is, you don't have to have 15 cups of coffee to feel like you're awake or anything other than just the fact that when you wake up, you're there. So we're going to see a beautiful Torah here in Parshat Tzav. Who was on the trip? Hey, Jer, perfect timing. Who was on the trip with us? Simon, Yeshua, and David. Next year, Stephen's going to come. Avi's coming back next year, too.
We're all on the trip.
We're all tripping. So we stopped by the kever of a big tzaddik that none of us had been to before. And that was the kever of R Pinchas of Koretz, remember?
Yes.
Remember that place where it was? Remember R Pinchas Koretz there? It was like a mamish on the road in the middle
of
the
parking lot.
Yeah, the parking lot, second stop.
Yeah. Wow.
You remember that one? Oh, you went there, not yet.
Not yet.
Right. Do you remember that, David? So, yeah, then afterwards I realized there was no way as a Kohen I could have been like, we couldn't see anything at night. We assumed that just don't go into the oil, but
the whole place was like,
yeah.
The whole place was like, all right, yeah.
Remember by Rabbi Pinchas of Koretz, he was like a Talmid Chav of the Baal Shem Tov, and why is he buried there? Remember what we said? He was on his way to Eretz Yisrael, actually. So he's buried there, like in the middle, it's like in the middle of like a parking lot in a, what was that town called? I don't remember the name of the town, just it was so inspiring. It was very inspiring. Here, Brent.
It's close to Annapoli,
right? Relatively close to Annapoli. So this is a Torah from the Pinchas of Koretz, the Imre Pinchas. If you see on the left column over here. And we're going to see, how do we figure out a way to wake up in the morning on fire? Just to wake up on fire. Now first, though, what's that?
Work harder the day before.
Well, first, go to the top right, because we're going to quote the pasuk from Tzav that we're going to be that this teaching is about. Tzav is Aaron v'zban of Lemor, zos Torah sa'ora. Command Aaron and his sons, telling them, this is the Torah of the korban ola. Hi ha'ola al mokda al mizbeach kol alayla ad haboker. The korban ola, it stays aflame all night. Al mizbeach kol ad haboker. It gets burnt thoroughly, through and through, throughout the whole night. Ve'esh ha'mizbeach tukad bo, and the fire of the mizbeach shall be, what's tukad, shall be lit, shall be in it. Right. Burning it all night long. Keep the fire going all night long. All right, you got one more here for Thomas. So Rabbi Pinchas Koretzer says like this, Hasiman sheyesh le'adam le'avchin, the siman that a person can check to see whether imamish served Hashem right with emes, and to kind of like check in and say, was my avodas Hashem today really good? Was it on? Was I on? Was it wanted? Was it accepted before Hashem? Gam im yashav kol hayom ala sefer. even if he sat all day long learning, yachol edabaze, a person can know. You have no idea how much I missed that, your coffee. In my heart, it's, when that happens, I know everything's right. I'm sorry. It's everything's okay for now. Amash, it's amazing what makes you feel at home sometimes. So check it out. I love you and miss you. That's it. So this is what he's saying. Gamim yashav kolim misal sefer, meaning you could be sitting learning all day long, But how do you know if the avodas Hashem of the day was mamash went up there and it was right and it was mitkabel before Hakadosh Baruch Hu? Dehine mitorah va'avoda she'adam oseh. From the Torah and the avodas Hashem that a person does, na'asa levush lenishmato. You create a cloth, levush, like, you know, halbasha, a cloth for your soul. Ve'al yedei zeh halevush hi ola bechol laila lemala, and through the levush that you put on your soul, it goes up every single night, up lemala, umitkarevet lekorban al hamizbeach. It goes close to being a sacrifice on the Mizbeach, al yedei Michal Kohen Gadol. Michal Kohen Gadol is brought down a lot as the one that comes and brings the korbanos and places it onto the Mizbeach. Aval, but if a person's im to'ato b'li dechilu urechimu, does anyone know what dechilu urechimu means? Love and awe. Ahava v'ira. But if a person's Torah is without love and awe, meaning you are sitting learning all day long, but that's just because that's what you do, but there's no love and awe in it. I mean, you get up for Shachmas every morning, you go to shul three times a day, but there's no love and awe in it. Lo parach le'ela. It doesn't fly up. It doesn't go up anywhere. Ein le'neshama levush. The neshama does not have a levush, does not have a clothing. Ve'en la aliyah, it does not have an ascending. It doesn't go anywhere. You ever hear the story that Baal Shem Tov one time walked into a shul, this chassidim? Mamish empty. And there's no one in the shul. And he tried walking inside. He's like, oh, I can't walk in here. Chassidim were like, why? He said, it's too stuffy in here. It's too stuffy in here. There's no one in here. What are you talking about, Rebbe? I mean, they didn't say what you're talking about, Rebbe, but they're thinking, like, What do you mean? There's no one inside here. He said, listen, davening is supposed to fly up. But when davenings don't have wings, they just stay in its place. I can't walk in here because there was a lot of davening in here, but it never went anywhere up. It just stayed over here. So he was so sensitive to it, he couldn't feel. He could feel that the davening, mamish, didn't have wings. So he couldn't walk into that shul. Now, how do we know? Lemaisa, how do we know if avodas Hashem and adav, if it got a levush? Lemaisa, how do we know these things? V'asiman leze im haya l'neshama aliyah. So what's the siman if our neshama had an aliyah? Im nit'orer baboker bihitlavut l'Hashem itbarach, asiman shaita nishmato korban. If you wake up in the morning with enthusiasm, if you wake up in the morning with excitement, if you wake up in the morning with a passion, with a jump, I want to go do this, I want to go learn today, I can't wait to daven today, that doesn't mean that something happened to you right now when you woke up in a good moment. It means that during the night, what happened? You brought a korban.
It means that during the day before.
That's really what it means. That's what Simon said before. Why? You're here. And you walked in with a smile. What do you mean? But really, it doesn't just happen at night just like that. Like Yeshua said, something happens even before that as well. So v'asiman lezeh im ha'yah l'neshama aliyah, im nis'orer baboker b'slavus l'Hashem yizbarach, az siman sh'aisa nishmas l'korban. U'me'oto eshel mizbeach, and from that same fire that was on the mizbeach, like the pasuk says, Eisha mizbeach tukad bo, libo mitlahev l'Hashem itbarach. Where did this fire that you woke up with come from? That's because your korban ola was on the mizbeach all night long. But really, how did this happen, Bemet? It doesn't just happen at night. It happens with your Avodat Hashem during the day, with passion, with Yira, with Ahava. That causes the night to be a fire night, which then brings you in the morning to have a fiery morning.
It's funny, we always think about the opposite, right? We always think, oh, I haven't been so long that I haven't been like really connected. I just need a good night's sleep and everything else like that, and I'll be okay. But what he's saying is like, no, you need to, in that place, work harder. And then when you wake up in the morning, you know that you'll be refreshed and regenerated and ready to go.
What? So what refreshes a person in this, in what you said?
The work that you do at the end of the day.
Right. The fire.
Right.
Yeah. V'zeh, this is what it means. Zot Torah Ta'olah. This is the Torah of the Korban Olah. Perush Leida. Im hayta le'torato aliyah. Im parcha le'ela. Meaning, to know. If his Torah had an aliyah, Torah Ta'olah. See what he did over here at Pinchas Koretzer. Torah Ta'olah, the Torah of the Olah, means, doesn't just mean the Korban Olah. It means, was there an Olah to your Torah? Did anything go up with the Torah that you learned during that day? In parcha le'ela, did it go up? Hi ha'ola, it's the one that goes up. Yeda in nishmato alta al mokda al mizbeach shel mala. His neshama will know if at night it went onto the mizbeach shel mala. Kol ha'layla ad ha'boker, all night long till the morning. Hayta korban al gabei ha'mizbeach. As vaday torato ola v'hilbisha l'neshama. And definitely, the Torah that he learned yesterday was like an ola, and it was a levush for the soul. Uvamei yedazot. And how do you know this? He's saying something very out there. If you realize this, he's like saying, how do you know if your avodas Hashem is gevalt? It's basically what he's saying here. How do you know? Dafka im beit oruto. Dafka. If when you wake up, you cut bo esh beislavus l'Hashem Yisparach. If there's a fire burning within you when you wake up in the morning, then you know that yesterday's avodas Hashem had wings. Yesterday's davening went somewhere. As siman sheze nishar me'esh ha'mizbeach she'ayta nishmato korban. It's a siman. This is left over from what happened to you the night before, which was probably a product and a result of what happened to you the day before. So without putting any pressure on anybody, how was your morning? How did it feel this morning? Ay vey, the nervous smiles. We're here right now, right? Come on, we're here. It's gewalt.
It hasn't been until tomorrow morning.
It's up to you. It's up to you. What's Shachar is going to be like tomorrow morning? Not Shachar's. What's Mode Ani going to be like tomorrow morning? Right? What's it going to be like? You don't have to run to a swarm store to buy a sefer to get excited for tomorrow morning. You just have to make sure that yesterday, whatever you were doing, had a levush, that it had some kind of a meaning to it, and it had wings. Parcha le'ela, and it went up. That's one beautiful piece from the Parsha, from Rabbi Pinchas of Koretz. Now...